I knew a man, Bojangles, and he danced for you.
You're filming?
In worn out
yes.
shoes.
What's his name?
Silver hair and ragged
shoes. Okay, I want to welcome everybody here today. Today is a great day. We have a great day to do this. First of all, I just want to go into why we're here today. When you welcome a pet into your home, they become very much a part of the family. And they become loyal companions, and that's why we're having this event today. Unfortunately, more than 40,000 pets die annually in house fires every year. Good news is that even more are saved thanks to the heroic efforts of the people that are standing behind me, the firefighters. Firefighters now know where to look for pets. Pets, of course, are scared during a fire, just like human beings are, and they seek the safety of hiding under couches, under beds, and so forth. And our firefighters know now where to look for the pets. However, they also need equipment in order to help rescue the pets. And so today we are giving out these cone-shaped oxygen masks that's going to be demonstrated very, very shortly and will help our firefighting four-legged family members. There is a saying that we are never so tall as when we stoop to help another. And whether that be another person or an animal, certainly that saying applies.
I'm taking a lot of pictures.
And I want to thank the people here today that are really demonstrating that they are giants. Among them are our firefighters, the people from the Dog Park Committee, the folks dedicating and donating these masks are really giants here today. So my sincere thanks goes out to each of you for this very, very important donation. I want to introduce and thank Patty Heath from Canine Control Company. She's going to do a demonstration for us in a second on how these oxygen masks work. So thank you, Patty, for the donation. Also with us today is Dory Schofield from Save a Pet, and certainly she knows firsthand how these masks help save the lives of pets. So thank you, Dory, for being here also. I want to recognize first all of the fire departments that are with us today. We have Middle Island Fire Department. We are in Middle Island. We have the Commissioner, Jeff Davis. Thank you, Jeff. We have our Chief, Craig Tunger, here today also. Thank you, Craig, for being here. Brighton Heights Fire Department. We have Chief Eden Rutter. Commissioner Chesley Ruffin. And Commissioner Kelly with us today. So thank you, Gordon Lewis, for coming and helping us with this. Okay, I want to turn it now over to Patty to show us how these masks work. Patty, you want to do that first? And I think we have a volunteer.
I'm going to try with Danny. They come in three sizes. We've got the small, and the medium, and the large. And then each fire truck we'll have them in a nice canvas bag. All three are in the one bag, and they can carry them on their trucks. So that if they, you know, have a seasoned animal, they can right away use one of the masks. And the smaller ones can also be used for kittens. They can be used for hamsters. They can be used for ferrets. They can be used for birds. They can be used for snakes. They can be used for whatever your pet is. So I'm not sure if Benny's gonna be okay, but we'll give it a whirl.
You
want to
just try where
you got that from?
Try the larger one. And now the tube comes off of here, as Councilwoman Pepper choked, and it goes into the oxygen tank. So we'll just see if it. And it has a.
Wait a minute.
And you see it has a tight fit to it, and that way if they hand it off to us, then you think, great, thank you.
Thank you. understand that our canine control company has donated enough masks, and Invisible Fence has donated enough masks for every fire department in the town of Brookhaven. So it's a wonderful donation. Again, our dog park committee is doing just a wonderful job. I'd like you to give them a hand. They are doing a wonderful, wonderful job, not only at the park, but in every aspect of dogs and helping pets throughout the town of Brookhaven. One of the things that they have gotten done is that they are donating 100 blankets to Brookhaven Animal Shelter, and that's from the dog park committee. Kim, Joe, Terry, and the dog park patrons. So thank you for that. I mean, those are very, very needed blankets for our animal shelter in the town of Brookhaven. Say the pet. Okay, say the pet.
Hi, everybody. I know all of you know firsthand that we lost 11 of our animals on August 5th in a house fire. And I am just so grateful for this donation to the town of Brookhaven, because I just feel like if 11 animals can be saved by this donation, then my animals will not have died in vain. And I hope that we can get every fire department on Long Island to have them, because so many people have multi-pets in the household. So and they are our family. My animals were my family, and I'm so thankful that my kids are okay, but my animals mean so much to me. And it's a comfort to know that animals' lives will be saved because of this donation. So thank you, and let's spread it further.
Yay! That was awesome.
Okay, I do want to introduce Chief Brother for a couple of words.
Good morning, everyone. Again, I just wanted to thank everyone for the donation. It's particularly important that we do provide this type of rescue equipment for our animals. I believe over 60 million families across the United States have pets in their homes, and they're just as important. Firefighters arrive on the scene, and quickly, you know, our main priority is human life, but the animals are just as important. They're very giving, they're very loving. They're part of the family, and having these rescue equipment particularly makes our job easier. As Connie stated, it's particularly difficult during a fire. Animals usually hide. It creates a problem for us during our rescue operations. In the past, we had to be creative and maybe take a cellophane cup and stick a hole through it and stick an oxygen tube through it to try to get 100% oxygen to these animals. With the addition of these masks, with the seal, we're able to get 100% oxygen, and their survival rates will be increased. So we thank you. Our community thanks you. Again, we thank Connie and the organizers for putting this together. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Okay, I do want to present a certificate of appreciation to Patty. This is an outstanding donation. It will help, as Dory said, it will help to save many, many animals within the town of Brookhaven who are caught in house fires. It not only helps our fire departments, give them oxygen, it also increases just the knowledge of, you know, the fire departments that, you know, this equipment is here, and I think it'll be more likely to be used. So, great donation. Thank you so much, Ben.
Thank you so much.
I knew a man, Bojangles, and he danced for you. Mr. Bojangles, dance. He danced for those at minstrel shows and county fairs. Throughout the South, he spoke through tears of 15 years, how his dog and him traveled about. The dog up and died, he up and died. After 20 years he still grieves. He said, I dance now at every chance in honky tonk.